that they are lauding this. Myself and the others who are part of the Women Human Rights Network across the country have been lobbying parliamentarians on all sides of the House. And one of the things that we find very frustrating is that among government MPs, they have still yet to use the word genocide to describe what is happening in Myanmar. And academics, reports that have come out over the last several years from Yale University, from Queen Mary University in London, have set out the stage for genocide, and this meets all those criteria. So thank you once again, and please, to the audience, I ask that you please go contact the PM's office. I've still got a petition on change.org, which has over 50,000 signatures. If you can't, if you haven't signed it, please share it. Because what is happening to the Rohingya in Myanmar today, from going on for the past 40 years, is no different than what happened to the Jews in Nazi Germany. And I speak as the husband of a woman who passed away, whose father survived the concentration camps. This is no different than that. And we weren't there in World War II. We missed the genocide. We didn't know about the genocide in Cambodia in the 70s. There was the Kurds in Iraq in the 80s. Then came Rwanda. Then came the Balkans. It just goes on. And never again has to mean never again. It cannot be just words. So please.
Thank you very much for that additional info. I think one of you had your hand up.
It's her. Can it, like, if you don't mind, can you just pick her?
And I her
since
her
you think
is, but her knows who she is.
Because she keep having her hand up, and also she had, like, can you pick both of them? You said three, right?
Sure. You tell them. I can't see you pointing at
them. And we'll take your question.
So just a couple of things. First of all, thank you, because I work with people trying to have compassionate dialogues with people in Canada who are a diaspora of other countries. And it does just go on and on. So the fact that you were able to give power to, you know, those of you who need to speak and to give voice to all of your experiences and to your parents is really, it's too emotional to have words. There's two things. First of all, I wanted to say this information has to go out in order for enough Canadians to feel passionate about doing their political part. And some of the things that we've done, and I live in a small town outside of Ottawa, is that our library has become a center of showing films like this. So how would we get a copy?
This guy, yeah.
That's cool, our first film. yeah, absolutely. I'm happy to connect with you. The film will be publicly available very soon on various video on demand platforms. We're working on trying to get as many as possible, but it will be available very soon on our website, www.imrohingyafilm.com. And we are trying to get it DVD copies into libraries and schools and universities and public libraries. So we're working to try and get that as much as possible, but let's connect and make that happen.
So Ahmed, who's next?
No, I just don't want to be like, I feel bad, you know, she's keeping it.
Thank you for taking my question, and thank you for sharing your story. It was really harmful and moving, and like you said at the beginning of the movie, after watching this film, you can all say that we're witness to it, and I feel very honored to have witnessed this, and along the lines sharing the story and then get out there. Do you have a presence on social media that people can follow and spread the word?
Yeah, so we are active on Facebook at I Am Rohingya Official. We also have a Twitter and Instagram account, which is just at I Am Rohingya. So yeah, follow us and and our website, imrohingyafilm.com. Right, there's a website.
If you see my picture, just double top it, you know?
Yeah, the website does have more information on what is actually happening in Burma as well, and we hope to keep updating that so it is more of a living document as opposed to something that is frozen in time. Yes. Yeah.
And feel free to connect with us. I mean, it's really us that runs all the social media, so if you send us a message, it'll go right to us. And if you have questions or if you want to connect about anything, ask us questions, get in touch with the cast. Just feel free to tweet us or message us, and it'll be us that responds. So, yeah.
And now you can pick whoever you want.
We have about 2 minutes left, but let's do a quick, if you can be quick, and we'll just take your questions, 1, 2, 3, 4. Quick questions, and then we'll let everyone respond.
Yeah, I'm a journalist, so I can do a quick question. Congratulations, first of all, on screening your first documentary. My question is specifically on whether you noticed a shift when you identify or say that you are Rohingya among your audiences. And I think maybe you could say you've noticed that it's been more in the news, but for you specifically, how has it changed when you voice your identity as Rohingya?
Okay, thank you. The second question. Okay, yeah.
So, my name is Linda Nisara. I'm a community blogger with the Society of Ontario. And I have a question regarding what that happens to all the wonderful casting this day had happened. So, how did that affect their emotions and the frustration of the displacements and their private story? Because now we are empowered, so we can speak on behalf of the parents and on behalf of the brain heads. But how they have been
So the question is, how are they dealing with the emotions? How would they have without the, if they hadn't done the play? It might be a tricky one to answer, but I'll let you work on that. And there was one at the back.
Hi, yeah. My question was just to the women in the film who were growing throughout the documentary itself. I just wanted to ask you if your experience is more than, like, to be able to meet up afterwards. You didn't have time to answer the question personally. I just wanted to know, how you grew and how your voices grew and how much strength and pride you feel now to call yourself a community.
Okay, thank you. And then I think, John, you had a question?
Well, good question's been asked. I'm just going to say something. I profoundly respect that you are Rohingya, but I want to tell you, I am thrilled that you are Canadians. So thank you for that.
Okay, so I am just going to open up the floor if you want to respond to any one of the three questions, or if there's something burning that you haven't had a chance to say and you really want to say it, this is your chance. So wave at me when you're ready to speak. Thank you.
Was that your question, Lauren?
Have you noticed a shift when you identify as Rohingya, the response that you get, compared to when you first started?
Well, when we first started, as Yasmin said in the video, she asked one of her friends there, who are Rohingyas, food or something like that. But that's changed now, because now when I go to my school and ask them, I actually did a presentation on ethnic cleansing in Burma, and they're I was actually shocked, they actually knew a lot of stuff about it. And they were supporting me on my presentation, do that and do that, this is important, this is not. And I was shocked, and I went up to them, how do you guys know about Rohingyas? They're it's been all over the news. And I'm where was this when, 2-3 years ago? They're we didn't really know and stuff. And then, when we did the drama and everything, I told my friends, and they were we want to come watch and everything. And I actually booked the tickets out for them. They ended up coming, and they went all over the school and told everyone else. And they were they came up to me, they're congratulations, I'm really proud of you, for the stuff you're doing. So from seeing you from a video to a real life act, they've actually touched their feelings, and some people got in tears and everything. I feel the momentum, it changed from 0 to 100 right away. Flash TV.
Hi, I just want to add a little bit more to these points.
it's spreading. So I'm actually happy. Like, a lot of people know, I guess, like, this is actually, like, I'm a professional or something. Like, anyway, so, like, I was actually surprised raising the play and, like, the crisis that Rohingya are facing in one of my class. I think it was fall term. I was completely surprised. I was like, oh, wow, like, someone do know. So my prof did raise the